Hey everyone, Ryan and Tom here. This week at SecureIt, we have something a little bit different for you.
Yeah, we're gonna show in its entirety a product review video that we shot about a little over a year ago for Granite Security Safe. It's a video, after we shot it, I watched it and we decided to hold off on releasing it. We just felt, I didn't wanna tear down a product or an idea without offering a solution. We now have the true safe, which is a true safe. If you need this level of security, this level of fire rating, we actually have a solution that works. In the review, the Granite Security Safe, it's one of the poorest attempts I've seen at trying to store guns, and it's expensive. And I point out some significant flaws in it. Now, we've had some comments in our social media about me being angry or coming across as, who's the angry guy in the videos? It's not anger, it's frustration. I'm not mad, but my background is building armories. Our whole company exists as a defense contractor, and we're probably now the largest builder of military armories. We build them all over the world. But we're also shooters, hunters, enthusiasts. And it was out of frustration for what I saw on the shelves, at Dick's Sporting Goods, at Gander Mountain, at all the stores. The products offered to store guns, in my opinion, were just flawed. Then you look at the ads, and I see what they're saying. I know it's BS. And it just got to a point where he said, this is crazy. So we made the decision to go into the retail market. So I'm not mad. I'm actually very excited. But I'm also very frustrated. And we're challenging a lot of beliefs. People have been sold a bill of goods for a long time. We're challenging that. When you challenge somebody's beliefs, what percentage of those people are going to get mad too? And I'm not looking to get into any kind of a pissing match or a fight with people. We present what we think is very good information based on, 15, 20 years of experience storing all sorts of rifles and weapons. So let's show the video in its entirety and let it fly. Today, guys, we're talking about the Winchester Defender Series safes. Now, it looks like Winchester is trying to copy our cradle grid system. They've made a design flaw that I'm going to point out. I've got a fix for you if you've got one of these safes. It's a pretty significant flaw. Now, what they've done is they've tried to copy our grid panel, and then they've produced these saddles in an attempt to give you some adjustability. Now, what they've got is a steel saddle. It's actually, if you put it on the safe, it's amazingly cheap for considering this is a $2,000 safe. It really is lightweight. The design is pretty bad here. The military used to use a saddle very similar to this back about 15, 16 years ago. And we made the determination that you cannot use these because what happens is this is steel. It's dipped in ABS. Now, Winchester's website says they're dipped in rubber. Well, that's not true. In my opinion, it looks like cheap ABS plastic. And what happens along the edges, as it dries, it wicks away and it produces a pretty thin layer of ABS. When your barrel sit on that, it wears through that very, very quickly. What you end up with, and this is what happened in the military to M4s, armories all over the country, is, I'm gonna try to zoom in on this. If you see it, I'll get a close-up of it. There's a line in that barrel where the bluing has been worn through. What happens is, as your gun sit there, it wears through this and the plastic splits and it goes metal to metal. And you end up getting, and it's very subtle, all of a sudden, one day, you're gonna notice a ring around the barrel of your guns. Now, if you've got some pretty high-end vintage, some old shotguns or barrels like that, you cut a line in the bluing like that, it's gonna be very difficult to fix. You're gonna have to probably strip the whole barrel, send it out, it's gonna be expensive, it may never be the same. So if you're using these saddles with this system, send us a note, contact us. We'll work a deal, we'll get you our saddles, the proper saddles. This is a SecureIt cradle. And we went through a lot of time to design this, working with US Army Special Forces to properly store firearms. It was well north of $100,000 for the tooling to produce this. Winchester didn't want to invest the time or money to do it. They also, I got a patent on this. So they made this cheap metal thing in an effort to try to copy us. So if you do have one of these safes, let us know. And we will get you the saddles. Now, Winchester, I'm going to pull this. This is right from their website. As strong as the Winchester legend, our gun safes embody the reliability, integrity that earned Winchester's title as American legend. Not a single detail is overlooked in our manufacturing process. When you see the Winchester safe name, you receive the best quality, blah, 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 blah. Well, it looks like Granite Security Products licenses the name. And what they do is they build safes. Now, they talk on their website about their facility and their state-of-the-art, I think it's Fort Worth, Texas. They make all this cool stuff and how great it is, American-made. It says made in China. I paid about $2,000. I think it was $1,900 for this safe. And what they've done is dialed it up with a bunch of stuff to make it look like something that should cost a lot more. The panels inside, they're 16-gauge. It's pretty lightweight. In fact, I bent this pretty badly when I pushed that saddle down. They've put a roof rack on top. And I'm not sure I get this one. If they're trying to play off of like a redneck hillbilly, put a rack on a truck and it's cool kind of a thing, I don't know. I'll show you some close-ups of this. In terms of construction quality at this price point, the welds are horrible. I've got two broken welds on here. It's really poor quality. At this price point, these things should be perfect. And they're not, and I don't even know why it's on here. It really makes no sense. All right, let's talk a little bit about the interior of the safe now. They've used these crazy saddles. I've got one here to go in the safe. A couple of the issues I see right away with it, and it's really frustrating, is a flat bottom to the safe. And if you've got an AR, this is an AR-15, if you just set it in there, there's nothing holding it in place. I've actually got to have it tipping almost forward a little bit so it leans in. But again, it's extremely unstable. If I've got some high-end optics or scopes on my guns, there's no way I'm putting them in here. It just isn't stable. Now, they talk about a pretty good-sized gun capacity. They've got little handgun pegs, which are a direct copy of ours. It's not a bad design. I mean, it works. They say it goes down to 22 caliber. It doesn't. It's a 9mm holder. The only way to do 22 would be to pull the sleeve off, and then you're metal to metal, and we would not recommend that. However, when you're using these saddles, if you're using the side louvers, putting a handgun on here, I'm taking up almost half the capacity of the safe. There's a reason in our products we don't build out in the sides. It's really inefficient use of space. It doesn't really work. It looks good. Empty in a showroom, at a store, maybe this looks good, but in reality, it's not very effective. So, I mean, what you've got here is a pretty inefficient system. You've got a lot of depth. The depth is offset to weight of the door so the safe doesn't tip forward. The depth doesn't buy you anything. You're not able to really do much with it. You've got a system that just doesn't hold the guns. If you've got this safe with this interior, contact us. We'll get you saddles. We also will get you the base unit, which is part of the cradle grid system, which gives you proper loading into the saddle so the guns are really secure and stay put. If you look at the security on this one, it's a residential security container. It's not a safe. It is a residential security container. Fire rating, it says 60-minute fire rating. We have an article on our website. It's gun safe corrosion, should you be concerned? And in that article, and there's a video in there, I really explain in detail about fire ratings and gun safes. And most of this is smoke and mirrors. Inside this safe, you've got carpeting, you've got drywall. And the carpeting is attached with glue that has formaldehyde. It's corrosive. The drywall has pyrite in it, which breaks down into sulfuric and sulfurous acids. You've got bacteria, ferrooxidants. They eat the pyrite, they create the acid. Ferrooxidants, used in the mining industry to strip metal from low-grade ore, eats guns. There's a reason they make anti-corrosion products for all these safes, because these things are toxic for guns. Our goal is to make sure that all the guns in America are properly stored. As we always say, respect for a firearm doesn't end when you close the door. And when you store a gun, we want it so when you open the safe, a cabinet, whatever you're using, retrieve your firearm, it performs perfectly. It performs identical to when you put it in. This system isn't going to do it. I think this is a poor attempt at trying to copy our cradle grid system. I'm flattered. I mean, they validated. They're saying that what I'm doing is right. Obviously, they're trying to copy us, but they should have just called me, done the right thing, and we would have licensed the technology to them, made it easy, and given you a better product. If you got this thing, call us. We will hook you up. We'll get this thing right. I just want to show you what you're getting for your money. It's a circular saw with it's a plywood blade, actually. That's a $2,000 safe, guys. That took me what? A minute and a half? Maybe? I just cut the damn thing in half. So guys, there are good safes out there. I'm not bashing every safe. Fort Knox makes a decent safe if you get their double-walled steel safe. Look at Bruce Pendleton, he makes a fantastic safe. But this stuff's crap, and it's being sold as quality. It's been sold for $2,000.
As we've said before, we're all about solutions.
We know there's a lot of questions, so we bring you the answer.